If Thresh does land a hook, we want to judge whether or not we should jump in. We have the mobility advantage in this lane, but if we ever E forward, we just want to make sure that we're getting the kill. Lastly, whenever you're in a matchup against two ranged champions, just go Doran Shield. It's safe, it gets you through lane, and overall, it's way more forgiving than Blade. With that all said, let's hop in. Starting off, Ezreal and Thresh ward the enemy jungle. This is an interesting idea, but it's one that we don't see very often. The idea here is to ward for the enemy bot lane's leash and harass them while they're trying to help kill the red buff. As they head back into lane, it's clear that the leash isn't happening from blue side, and they're now in a bit of an unfortunate position. While we're okay with giving up lane control, we didn't really want to give it up for free. However, that's just what happens when you try to play the numbers and invade like this and it just doesn't pan out. That said, going for a strategy like this in lower elo, where junglers usually start on the bot side more often, is something you should definitely keep in mind for your own games, since you'll be able to chunk out your lane opponents and tilt them before the lane even starts. Immediately when Doublelift gets into lane, he's able to get a Q onto Bard. This was kind of laziness from Bard, but keep an eye on how DL is positioning to consistently land his Qs. Whenever a Q from Thresh lands, any skill shots you have are free to land, so Doublelift gets another easy Q onto Bard. They're able to get a ton of damage and force Bard's flash from the Ignite from Thresh, and that's an excellent trade. Doublelift didn't continue chasing for two reasons though. First, Kaylin is getting hits on him already, which he wants to avoid, and second, these three casters would also start to hit him as well. Even though they were able to burn Bard's flash, Doublelift is still respecting the Caitlyn range and letting it push into him. This is a situation where you don't want to completely change your game plan just because you had an unexpected advantage occur. In this case, he just wants to continue farming and enjoy a little bit less pressure from Bard for the meantime. As he moves up to hit these casters, look at how he moves up just a little bit more to try and hit a Q. This is a small skill shot related thing, and he doesn't actually hit the Q here, but it's still an important thing for